Hi, it's Lily Manda for Portrait Creatives. In this video, we are going to talk about how to remove the 10 lines on the skin. In Malta, it's sunny all the time during the summer. All you need, just a couple of hours under the sun, then you will get these 10 lines. Okay, it's pretty easy, almost unavoidable, unless you wear something strapless. So I'm going to use this image to demonstrate to you, like, how do you remove those 10 lines if you accidentally you have them. This is a photo of a beautiful dancer, Martina Kalea. We have worked together with some dance projects, and let's have a look at this image. Here's my pen. So you can see it's pretty obvious she has these 10 marks, and then we're going to zoom in. First thing, you look at image. If you want to blend the color in to the same as the area around, you have to look into two things. One is the brightness. Is the brightness differences? In this case, yes, it's brighter, right? To compare to the skin next to it. And then the second thing is the color. Is there a color shift? Yes, because the tanned skin, it's more orange and red. Okay, so these are the two things we need to adjust it. I'm going to select this area, it's more obvious. I'm going to roughly select this area. Okay, I'm going to add curves, a layer adjustment. And then I'm going to just reduce the brightness. So I'm just click, drag it down like somewhere here. Like when you see this part of color is similar to the color here, then that's about right. And I want to add a little bit redness in it. So I just change the red channel and then drag it up a little bit. Like this is almost similar. You can see here and here is quite close, right? And I'm going to reduce the blue tone a little bit. So I'm just going to reduce tiny bit. I think that's too much. I think about here. So the second thing is I'm going to go in, just change the brush, B. And then I'm going to size down my brush. And you can use bracket to do that. And I'm going to use a very soft brush and just paint over. Like this is some, this is the, we're gonna mask this out because we don't need this part selected. Okay, like this. About that. And then I go to properties for layer mask and just add some feather to blur the edge out, right? Okay, so I do feel like there's too much yellow tone in it. So I'm going back to go to blue and I'm going to change the blue, add a little bit blue on it, just tiny bit. So you see it's almost blended, right? Okay, that's pretty close. Okay, that's just too much. So I'm going back down. It's about here. I'm just going to blend it a little bit more. Maybe just add a little bit further. That's too much. So coming back down. So about here. Okay. The reason I use curve adjustment is I can still keep the original texture. Okay. I'm not moving the texture around. And in this way, we can make sure it's high quality results. And then that's before, that's after. It looks tons better. And I'm going to zoom out because when I'm zoom out, I can see much better. So obviously it is still a little bit too bright, right? I'm going to just bring it down a little bit. Okay, so obviously it's a little bit too bright when I zoom out, have a look. So I'm going to RGB channel and then just going down a little bit, something like this, or going up a little bit, just tiny bit, it would really help. Right, something like that. Let me see before and after. I think that's too bright, so I'm going to use opacity now. 9%, something like that. Okay, and I'm going to zoom out and select the layer mask and then change the brush B and paint the other side with white. Okay, so this side obviously is a little bit too dark. I'm just going to paint over. I'm going to change the brush size. Going to change the brush opacity to maybe like this. And then paint it back again. like this. Looks tons better, right? Let me see before and after. Okay, that's pretty close, but not exactly. Okay, then I would just, let me just paint a little bit here. Okay, so like that. And then I will go to patch tool to merge the edges together so they will look all very similar. And I'm just going to add another new layer and merge all this adjustment and merge into a new image. And I hold on, Command, Alt, and Shift, and E. So that's a new image. And I'm going to patch tool. So I'm just select the edges very carefully, like that, and just patch them. Okay, so it will look all very blending. And here the same, I'm just gonna select it, and so I just want the edges to look more blended, like this. Okay. Let me see. So zoom out. So the 10 marks are disappeared, right? So you can't see anything now. That's before, that's after. Okay, so I can see here it's too dark. I can also just remove them to another patch here. Let me see. That's before, that's after. Before and after. Maybe here is a little bit too dark. I am going to just move it to here. Okay. The before and after. Okay, so it looks tons of better. The 10 marks are disappeared. So you might wonder, like, maybe I just used patch tool right from the beginning, right? Yes, you can, absolutely you can. But then you will change overall texture. And then patch tool is all about blending the edges together. So you might still see some 10 lines, or you might still have some problem with the texture. And in this way, we'll minimize all these problems and we'll bring out the highest quality. And those tools like patch tool, or use healing brush tool, or use stem tools, if you already blend the colors very, very similar, it will help the tools to do a better job. Okay, so this is just the tutorial today. If you have any questions, leave in the comment down below. And I hope you get values out of this video. And we will keep uploading some helpful tutorials. So make sure you subscribe to our channel. And I'll see you in the next video.